Hello, welcome. Today we are going to be looking at Lewis Methason method. Lewis Methason method of solving for the number of stages needed for a complete or good separation to happen in a distillation column. So in the previous class, I distinguished between a binary system and a multi-component system. And how did I do that? I said that a binary system is that distillation column that receives a feed that is composed of just two components. So it is separated at the distillate and bottom. Whereas a multi-component system is that system that receives a feed that contains several components, like crude oil. Crude oil contains propane, methane, exemplate, you understand? So in real life situation, you find out that what you actually see is a multi-component system. For you to determine the composition for a binary system is very easy, because if you say that a binary system comprising of A and B, if the composition of A is this, you can easily say that the composition of B is that of A minus total feed, or total feed minus that of A will give you that of B. But for a multi-component system, it is different, and that's why we explore several methods of solving for those compositions in order to determine the number of stages.
So one of those methods is what we call Lewis-Methason method.
This Lewis-Methason method is a very, very important method of solving for the number of stages. It assumes a constant molar fluid. Very, very important. Assumes a constant molar fluid. Lewis-Methason method is a state-by-state method for calculating the number of stages of fluid needed for a given separation. It involves assuming constant molar fluid, and making material and energy balance equations. So we are going to be using material and energy balance equations. Once you assume a constant molar overflow, you make a material and energy balance equation. And once you do that, you can now use your operating lines, which I'm going to show us how to do that. Now, the procedure involves calculation from top or bottom towards the feed point. And once the composition that you get solving from top to the feed point is the same as similar to the one you get solving from bottom to the feed point, you see that what is called mesh has occurred. This mesh is simply the margin of the compositions at the feed point. So then you can now determine the number of stages using the operating line equation. This I'll give you in detail in the next subsequent classes where I'll be giving us an example. Now, for you to use a Lewis-Methason method, there are things that must be specified before you can use the Lewis-Methason method. Number one is the feed composition. You have to tell us the feed composition, what the feed is composed of, you understand? Which involves you telling us also the flow rate and the composition. Number two, the distribution of the key components. You have to be able to identify for us the light key component, the light key component and the heavy key component, as well as the non-light key and non-heavy key. Very, very important. One product flow, you must have to give us the quantities for the one polar flow. You have to give us the reflux ratio, very, very important. You know that reflux ratio is the reflux over distillate. You have to also give us the column pressure, the pressure of the column. You have to also give us the assumed value for the distribution of the non-key. After getting the light key and the heavy key, you have to give us the assumed value of the distribution of the non-key component. So once you have these six things, you can then use Lewis Methason method. Lewis Methason method, very, very important method, which involves stage-by-stage calculation. In using Lewis Methason method, it's very, very important that you understand this. So you're using the Lewis-Methason method. You have your column. Then you have a feed that consists of A. Is your feed. Consists of A, B, C, D, and so C. You're feeding it inside this column. So you have the stage, let's say stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. Then you have the feed point, this is the feed point stage. You have another stage, you have another stage, you have another stage. So
So using Lewis Methason method, you calculate from down, from up here to down, or like this. So the points where the composition of this field are similar, you say that we have what we call mesh, which is at the feed point. We are going to be doing these calculations. But very, very important, it's always good that you know that if a mixture is composed of, if a mixture is composed of A, B, C, D, and so, so, and so, so, you can actually write the mole fractions. The mole fractions, you can write it as X, A for this, X, B for this, X, C for this, and X, D. So this is the mole fraction, which is simply the part of A that is inside the total, the part of B that is inside the total, the part of C that is inside the total, the part of A that is inside the total. Very, very important. So this is the mole fraction in the what? Liquid. And the mole fraction in the gas is part of A that is inside the total, the same way. So X is for the liquid, whereas Y is for the gas. You understand? Because once you feed this into here, you're going to find out that this the feed will be separated into liquid and vapor. You understand? Liquid and vapor. So the part of A that is inside the liquid is represented like this. The part of B that is inside the liquid section is represented like this, because this is the boiling the heat is supplied to this column. So when the part of A that is inside the vapor is this. So this is what we are going to have. So that when you say the part of A inside the total, the part of B inside the total is going to equate to 1. The same way, the part of the gaseous part of A inside the total plus the gaseous part of B inside the total, when you add them up, if you add it up, it's going to equate to 1. Then when you add this up as well, because it's more fractions, you know, when you add up fractions, you get 1. So when you also add this plus, it doesn't stop at this, so you can continue. It will also be equal to 1. I'm making this reference because we're going to be using it when we're doing the solvent. Now, if we say that YA over YB plus YB over YB plus YC over YB plus YD over YB, we have such, if we divide through by the by one of the key components B, we are going to have 1 over YB. So this is what we are going to have. Very, very important that we know that. And also, we are going to also have that YB is equal to XB all over the summation of relative volatility of A with respect to B times XB. Very, very important. This relationship, we are going to be using it. So we have this is equal to relative volatility. You can call it volatility, but when it is A, we call it relative volatility of A with respect to B. And from this relation, we can write finally that YA is equal to, very, very important, you need to get this equation, YA is equal to
relative volatility of yield with respect to the all over. Summation of relative volatility of A with respect to B. XB. So this very question is very, very important. And you're going to be using it. You can do it for B, you can do it for C, you can do it for the as well. You're going to be using it when we are considering our Lewis Methason method that we'll be doing in the subsequent class. Very, very important. This method is a stage by stage calculation procedure. You understand? Where you calculate either from the top or bottom. But there is always a mesh where the composition that you're solving from here up is similar or equal to the composition that you're solving from here down at the feed point. Very, very important. So at that point, you can now do what we call equilibrium, you do the operating line using the operating line equation. Once you get that mesh, once you get your mesh, use the operating line equation to find the number of stages. So, and for you to identify the operating line equation, you need to use what we call material balance. For you to get the equilibrium balance, you need to know about this. That the fraction, once you have a feed that is composed of A, B, C, D, and so on, and you feed it into the distillation column, you're going to have the liquid component of each of them, A, or B, or C. And you're also going to have a vapor component of them. So that liquid component of A is known as XA, mole fraction. Part of A that is inside the liquid of the total. The part of B that is inside the liquid of the total is known as X. The part of C that is inside the liquid of the total is known as X. The part of D that is inside the liquid of the total is known as X. And when you sum them, you have one. The same way, the part of A that is inside the vapor is known as YA of the total. The part of B that is inside the vapor of the total is known as YB. The part of C that is inside the vapor is known as YC and so on. And when you add them up, you also get one because this is no fraction. You understand? When you divide through by a key component, say B, you have this and it's also equal to 1 over YB. And this YB is simply equal to the part of B that is inside the no fraction of XB. All over the summation of relative volatility of A with respect to B times X. Very, very important. And you can, from these two, derive this general equation that YA, which is the part of A that is inside the vapor, the mole fraction of B, is equal to XA, relative volatility of A with respect to B, all over summation of relative volatility of A with respect to B. So take note of this equation and understand this before we can get to this Methason method. Please, if you like this video, click on the subscribe button so that you get our videos whenever they drop. We have been subscribe videos on this explaining everything about unit operation, advanced unit operation. So please like this video, share it.